Papa Roach have gone through many, many changes in their sound throughout their career. With several EPs and 10 studio albums under their belt, perhaps it should not come as a surprise. But it seems that it was in the nature of this band to constantly experiment with different sounds and styles from the very moment the band was formed. Releasing their first major record in 2000, Papa Roach belongs to the second wave of nu metal bands. When the genre began to lose its flair and has become more mainstream with less and less creativity, the band managed to bring some originality and reinvigorated the genre to some extent. Probably because their influences seem to have come from older bands such as Rage Against the Machine and Faith No More. The band had more raw rock and punk rock sensibility to their sound. Jacoby's rapping style stood out due to his unique and energetic delivery. The band began to form in January of 1993 in Vacaville, California, with lead singer Jacoby Shaddix meeting drummer Dave Buckner on the Vacaville High School football field. Trombonist Ben Luther and bassist Will James joined them shortly after. Lead guitarist Jerry Horton from nearby Vanden High School took some persuasion to join the band, as he was a metal guitarist, but at the time the band was playing something like this. The band has started out as something completely different to what they are known for and have been throughout their professional career. Beginning as a funk band reminiscent of bands such as Red Hot Chili Peppers and Primus, with more playful approach to the atmosphere of their music that was quite bass driven and minimalistic vocals with practically no singing. Soon the band played at school's talent show performing their version of Sunfire by Jimi Hendrix. The band ended up losing the talent show. Ben Luther, the trombonist, left the band in March 1993, just 2 months after the band's formation. Papa Roach was very active at this point, regularly practicing, gigging and touring, using every opportunity they got. In 1994, they released their first EP, titled Potatoes for Christmas. In 1995, Papa Roach released yet another demo titled Caca Bonita. On this effort, Papa Roach have drastically changed their sound into much more aggressive and with more serious atmosphere. This is also when the band began to lean towards nu metal sound, reminiscent of early Deftones and Limp Bizkit. In 1996, original bassist Will James was replaced with longtime roadie Tobin Esperanza. And it is with this lineup Papa Roach would be most known for and will earn a platinum status. On February 4th, 1997, the band produced their debut studio album entitled Old Friends from Young Years. On this record, the band's sound started to take the shape of the sound they are known for, though this record is significantly heavier and more dissonant than any of their future releases to date. I'm running with this, yeah, on his knife. Never be hard. He's got a followed by yet another EP entitled Five Tracks Deep, and their final independent release in 1999, Let 'Em Know, which included songs that would end up on their major debut release in Fest and follow up Love Hate Tragedy. The success of Let 'Em Know garnered attention from major record label Warner Music Group, that even provided a small sum of money for the band to produce a promo demo CD with help of producer Jay Baumgartner. Warner Brothers was not impressed with the final record, however, and have decided not to sign Papa Roach. Though the demo included future hits such as Infest, Last Resort, Broken Home, Dead Cell, and She Loves Me Not. Luckily, the band was picked up by DreamWorks Records soon after. In October of 1999, the band entered the studio to begin work on their debut major release, Infest, which included songs from their old material and three newly written songs. Infest was released on April 25th, 2000, and sold 30 and 1,000 copies in its first week of release.
Cut my life into pieces, this is my last resort.
After making their first music video for Last Resort, the band embarked on a series of tours with acts such as Limp Bizkit, Eminem, E40, Xzibit and Ludacris, and later were supported by Linkin Park and Head PE on their headlining tour Master Bay. Last Resort peaked at number 1 on the Billboard Modern Rock Tracks chart, success of which helped reach Infest position number 5 at the Billboard 200 album charts. The band's worldwide popularity grew very fast, which was evident from their Ozfest tour, where the band had the privilege to play on main stage in both US and UK. As of 2010, Infest has sold more than 8 million copies worldwide, with 3 million in US, and is their best-selling album to date. After successfully touring worldwide, the band returned to the studio to work on their follow-up album, Love, Hate, Tragedy.
Now, round and round, times are rewriting up, damn down. It's making me sick, relationships is getting ill. This social man, on the real, could you feel what I feel, what's the deal, girl? Tearing up each other's work, we should be in harmony, boy and girl. Yeah, it's a promise we made back in the day. We told you that things wouldn't be this way. I think we should work this out. So my memory is being set.
Even though the album did not outsell Infest, it managed to chart higher in both the US and UK album charts. The album has sold over 500,000 copies in US and has been certified gold also in Canada and UK. The album has sold over 3 million copies worldwide. Love Hate Tragedy is focused more on clean singing and less rapping this time around, though the band maintained their nu metal sound, including the two singles She Loves Me Not and Time and Time Again. The band toured in support of Love Hate Tragedy from 2002 to early 2003. The album was well received by critics and fans despite some divide. In late 2003, Papa Roach wrote and recorded their third major label album. The band worked with well-recognized producer Howard Benson, and this would become the band's first attempt at stepping away from the nu metal sound they were previously known for. This would also become the first album that does not feature signature rapping by lead singer Jacoby Shaddix. Perhaps it was a welcome change for the band, as Getting Away with Murder outsold Love, Hate, Tragedy. Much of the success was due to the popularity of the album's second single, Scars.
I tear my heart open, I sew myself shut. My weakness is that I care too much. and my scars remind me that the past is real.
Scars was ranked at number 36 as the greatest song of 2005 and as the most successful song of the year by Billboard, becoming the band's first and only song to be included on Billboard's year-end charts. In addition, Scars was the band's first song to cross over to top 40 radio since their breakthrough hit Last Resort. As of 2012, the album has sold over 5 million copies worldwide, of which 1 million for the US. It is their second best-selling album after their debut in Fest. Also their first and only album to have at least two Hot 100 hits. Critical response to Getting Away with Murder was mixed. At Metacritic, the album received an average score of 59, based on 8 reviews. However, it did gain more positive response from the fans than their previous effort. As most nu metal bands at that time, Papa Roach was not an exception and branched out from nu metal scene and would not return to the elements of their root sound until 2012. Instead, the band decided to experiment with different styles of rock throughout the years.